Hey, I'm Charlotte Lawrence, and all eyes on me because, I'm fun, I'm cool, like, I'm nice. We can, all eyes on me.
Telling me you love me, but I've heard it before. Staying out till the morning, I can hear the door. Telling me you're different, but you're just like the rest. I can smell all the whiskey and the smoke on your breath. I don't think you know this, but you're so predictable. Texting her behind my back and acting like I don't, but I already know. Talking in your sleep. Oh, and you've been messing around on me. I thought I told you once before. Oh, I guess you wasn't listening. So I'll wait till the morning. Might just let you sleep in. Won't give you a warning. Just know that I'm leaving. Talking in your sleep. Oh, and you've been messing around on me. On me. And say that you want me, that you want me back. Wanna talk me sober, no one to that. Swear that you're different, but you're still like the rest. So predictable, texting her behind my back and acting like I don't, but I already know. Yeah, I already know this. Cause you've been talking in your sleep. Oh, and you've been messing around on me. I thought I told you once before. She's so predictable. Texting girls behind my back and acting like you don't, but I already know. Oh, yeah, I already know. Cause you've been talking in your sleep. Oh, you've been messing around on me.
Thank you, guys. I consider being born and raised in LA a curse and a blessing. I think I'm very, very, very lucky because, I was able to get a very good read on people at a very young age. I grew up, my parents are in the entertainment business, so I grew up kind of around the light in the heart of LA with everything going on. And, through that, I was able to kind of figure out when people are fake or, in it for the wrong reasons and figure out, like, how people kind of maneuver in LA, because I do believe that some of the worst people you'll ever meet are in LA, but I also strongly believe that the best people in the world that you will ever meet come to LA, because if you really think about it, like, people from around the world in every city from different random places come to LA to follow their dreams, and it's just like, LA is filled with the most talented, creative, interesting, inspiring people. I've been signed with IMG Models since I've been like 12 years old, and I love them. They're incredible, and you know, now it's like we work as a team, you know, and they give me music opportunities and we do cool music things, and it's like I've separated from being like a model, you know? But from that, from starting that, before I got very serious about my music, meaning like before I started releasing stuff and genuinely being out in the world as like a musician, I had a sort of following that was following me because, you know, I was modeling and I was doing cool stuff with cool people, whatever. And I mean, I think now it's like, I post what I want to post on Instagram. Like I post singing videos all the time. I hope people don't get too bothered with them. I literally do it like every single day. And I mean, people that follow me, like I can tell, you know, from the people that are there for the music and for not, but I try to make it a point to be like, no, I'm a musician, like this is my passion. I will never, ever, ever write a song that doesn't mean something to me. And, you know, a lot of my songs are literally word for word stories of something that happened, or one day of events that I wrote word for word, or like 50 songs about one guy that hurt me or that I loved or whatever it is. I've sang my songs hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times, and I know it's just gonna keep on growing, but every time I connect with that emotion because I, you know, I remember how I felt when I was writing that. And I think my advice to people that are experiencing love for the first time or heartbreak for the first time is just to really get in your feelings about it and then be open about it, whether it's through art or through speaking to your friends or, you know, finding another thing that makes you very happy. I first of all have the most amazing like friends and family who just every time I walk into a room will play this song and be like, haha, look, we're playing a song. But my fans and, you know, people that listen to my music and reach out to me and be like, this song helped me because blank, or I felt the same way that you did, or oh my God, I broke up with my boyfriend because of this. Like, it's so cool to me because I'm like, this is how, you know, I get through my hard times is by writing this music. And it's so cool to, you know, hear about people getting through what they're going through and relating to my music, like in a kind of similar sense. I just released a song called Stole Your Car. It's super fun. It's one of my favorite new songs that I've released. If you haven't listened yet, go give it a listen. And then after that, I'm releasing another single called Bloodstream, which is one of my favorite songs I've ever written. And then another EP called Reckless. I'm gonna release a full project again. And all the while, I'm gonna be on tour. So come out and watch me. Come out and see me, guys. I'm going September 11th, I think, to Europe. And I'm doing Europe, and then I'm doing America, and the whole shebang. I'm Charlotte Lawrence, and you're tuned in to Ones to Watch.